Getting 25 laps of scheduled distance here on this one. Coming to green here on this one. Green is out, and here we go. 25 laps of distance. And a Mike Marler going to jump out in front here in the early going here. Ernie Gingrich is second. Jody Puckett riding in third. Brad Dyer fourth. Brad Hall fifth as they contest the opening lap of the 25-lap modified main event. Double file racing back there behind the top five. Jimmy Dalton rides in sixth, A.J. Garber seventh, Skyler Marler eighth, Austin Francis ninth, and the 312 of Concord, North Carolina's Rick Brown completes the top 10. Meanwhile, up front, Mike Marler sitting in the seat of an open wheel modified this weekend, the 2016 Knoxville Nationals for the Lucas Oil Model Dirt Series winner, leads Ernie Gingrich here in this one. With former 201 Speedway track champion Jody Puckett out of Melbourne, Kentucky in the J3, holding down the three spot. The winner down at Boyd Speedway back on January 28th with the Bruce Bill Performance Ironman Modified. Brad Hall rides in the four spot. He has a Brad Dyer in the 20 and the two of Jimmy Dalton race side by side for fifth. Yes, Marler continues to lead the way again, 25 laps of scheduled distance in this main event. For the modified, your non-qualifiers event for the Great Late Models needs to be getting staged up. You are coming up next. Yes, Mike Marler continues to lead the way in that number one. And he's going to start the process of working traffic here momentarily. Gingrich is second. Brad Hall quietly on the move. He's worked that Bruce Built House car up to the third spot now. The B1 of Brad Hall on the move. If you remember back here, I forget if it was at the hangover or the leftover, he started back in about the 21st spot and rolled his way up into the top five before it was said and done. So he definitely knows how to work his way around this racetrack. And he'll set his sights on second place running Ernie Gingrich at this point. As the 50 of Amos Bunch, he's going to call it an afternoon. He'll pull the 50 Bandit race car machine into the infield as Marler now. Going to have to start the process of working slower traffic. First two cars he's going to encounter be the F5 of Richard Clue and the 1K machine of Logan Kirkman. He has that work off turn four down the front straightaway. Marler will work under the F5 machine, and he'll have him cleared. Gingrich holds down second. Brad Hall riding in third. Jody Puckett is fourth as Brad Dyer in the 20 and the deuce of Jimmy Dalton continue to battle side by side for fifth. Kirkman up high, almost got the concrete as Marlon went by him and put him a lap down. And we'll have 10 laps complete right here. 10 laps in, 15 remain for race leader Mike Marler in the speedy towing number one machine. Ernie Gingrich rides in the bridesmaid spot still. Brad Hall third. Jody Puckett is fourth in the J3 machine. Jimmy Dalton in the two, currently sitting in fifth. Brad Dyer sixth, Skyler Marler seventh, Austin Francis eighth, A.J. Garber ninth. And the J4 Wayne James is your 10th place car at this point. As Gingrich gonna move up on the high side and try to follow in Marler's footsteps and see if that part of the racing service any better and will allow him to close in on the leader a bit. As we are right around the halfway position in this event. Marler set to put the 61 machine. That is Eric Hill. He'll put him a lap down here through turns three and four and down the front straightaway. Here at 411 Motor Speedway, the drivers having to fight some glare from that sun as they exit turn two and work down the back straightaway here. Gingrich, the second place car, going to be held up by the slower machine of Hill momentarily, and that's going to let third place running Brad Hall close in on him a bit. He has that pair of machines working off turn number four down the main straightaway. Marler has been on the point the entire way, trying to close this deal out and lead it start to finish. He set fast time and trying to just dominate today. Next car he'll have to negotiate here off turn number four is going to be the 69 of Albany, Kentucky driver Tim Patrick. He'll try to put him a lap down. As those two have turned a lot of laps together up at Lake Cumberland Speedway over the course of their careers, and Marler will put the 69 of Patrick a lap down. Gingrich now does set to do the same, but he's got a back bumper full of Brad Hall as they work off turn number four down the main straightaway here. With just a handful of laps remaining in this 25-lap modified main event. And Hall looking to the inside of Gingrich. They're side by side for the second spot down into turn number three. Gingrich trying to keep Hall behind him. Hall stuck right to the bottom of the racing surface. Gets a run on Gingrich down the main straightaway, but not able to make a move as the pair enters turn number one. As race leader Mike Marler right now following the T92, the next car he's got to try to put a lap down. That is a Knoxville, Tennessee's Billy Palmer. He has Ernie Gingrich trying to keep a hard-charging Brad Hall behind him here in the closing laps of this 25-lap open-wheel modified main event. As Gingrich closed in right there on Marler in the corner, but lost a bunch as they came off the corner. And Hall trying to work beneath him, but not going to be able to do so. Two turns, three and four, going to change his line. Now he'll fall back in line behind Gingrich off turn number four. Marler clear of the Billy Palmer machine. As Hall looks beneath Gingrich again, but Gingrich will close the door on him in turn number three as Marler comes off turn number four. There'll be five laps to go this time by, five to go for race leader Mike Marler in the number one. Get Ernie Gingrich still in second, Brad Hall third, Jody Puckett fourth, and a Jimmy Dalton in the two, still battling with Brad Dyer for that fifth position. Four to go now. Marler keeping a pretty comfortable lead over Gingrich. Gingrich slips a bit coming off two. That may open the door for Hall to go to the bridesmaid spot down into turn number three. They may have bumped wheels a bit there, but Gingrich gonna hang on to the second position for the time being. Marler moves up the racing surface as they work off turn number two down the back straightaway that time. Brad Hall continuing to try to find a way around Ernie Gingrich, but has been unsuccessful up to this point. As the lap's winding down here now in this one, Mike Marler sets that machine down into turn number one more time. Yes, second place Gingrich battling with the slower car of Greg Brown as they work through slower traffic there off of turn number four. And that's 23 in the books. We're going to be looking for the white flag next time by. Hall still trying to battle Gingrich and get that second position as Mike Marler works off turn number four to the white flag. One lap to settle it here in the 25 lap. Frostbuster 25 for the open wheel modifieds. Down the back straightaway they go for the final time and into turn number three. Off of turn number four, returning to his roots this weekend, Mike Marler of Winfield, Tennessee will win the Frostbuster 25 for the modifieds. Ernie Gingrich will be second. Brad Hall will finish in third. Jody Puckett will come home in fourth. And Jimmy Dalton completes your top five. I need three of these also, Carolyn. And he get here, you give him a big round of applause. Winfield, Tennessee's Mike Marler wins the Frostbuster 25 for the modified division. And he'll get his, make his way around to the other side of the car. We'll get a few words here with him momentarily. And congratulations, Mike Marler, picking up a cool $1,000 this weekend, getting to do it close to home. I heard Chris ask you there earlier. You had to have some fun out there this weekend. Congratulations, young man.
Yeah, I had a good time. I love racing the modifieds. My heart's really in them. And first race I've got to run in a long time, so it was fun to get to come out. And thanks for everybody staying out and watching us here. You know, I don't know how close anybody was behind us, but I think we you know, the trick slick track, and we all went flag to flag, not a bunch of cautions and stuff. So I think all the modified guys done a good job.
The 9G of Ernie Gingrich finished second place to you. It looked like maybe he was a little bit better entering, especially in turn one and two, but you had so much forward traction coming up off the corners. Those guys, they couldn't do anything with you coming off the corner.
Yeah, it was fun. Our car was good. This is actually one of the cars that I used to, or just like the car I used to run back when I run modified, so it's kind of an old car, but Rick Ogle and them guys at that Performance Chassis and Jimmy Owens and them built those, so it's they still do a good job, it looks like.
Give a big round of applause, Mike Marler, winner of the Frostbuster 25 for the Modifieds here at 411 Motor Speedway.